All right, guys, I'm leaving the rest stop about an hour outside of our destination, which is a ReStore in Lima, Ohio. Found another interesting find. Not bad, even though somebody painted it blonde.
What's up, guys? It's your boy PhilcoBAH coming back at you with another live installment. Today, for your viewing consideration, 1960 Philco Predicta Continental, aka otherwise known as the Danish Modern. This is arguably the most sought after Predicta for collectors. It retains the most value historically through auctions and private sales that I've experienced, done myself, or heard about through secondhand. This set I went 14 hours one way to Kansas City, Missouri to pick up. It was a lead tipped off to me by a close friend and Predicta contributor, Ben Wilmore. So I went and drove and bought this set sight unseen outside of the couple pictures, which made it look relatively clean, but it looked dusty. I wasn't disappointed when I came to pick it up. As you can see based off the video in front of you, the condition's really awesome. Not only is the condition amazing, but unlike any other Predicta I've come across personally, this set also has the original owner's manual. You don't find paperwork for Predictas, let alone original owner's manual, let alone for the Predicta Continental anywhere. So to say that this set was a rarity is an understatement. I was really excited as well when I picked this set up because the original owner's family had the set plugged in. It didn't have a full raster, but it did have a horizontal line denoting that something with vertical deflection went. But just the fact that it had a bright looking screen gave me hope the CRT was good, and I paid them promptly and had them unplug it, just because you really shouldn't leave these things plugged in. My excitement was short-lived, just because I've been working with a celebrity client, and he when he saw the rarity involved with this set, he made me an offer I couldn't refuse. I'm very fortunate that I was in that position, but this is no longer mine, so I'm back on the hunt for another Continental. I had one prior, and I had decided to sell it as well, just needing some roof repair. So I had sold that one previously, and I thought this one was going to be its replacement, but it was short-lived.
All right, guys, so here's what the Predicta Continental looks like with the back off. Noteworthy items, 10L43 chassis. Interesting that it has an A at the end. Maybe that denotes it's a first year or first run. Purely speculation on my part. Also, the two nice little clean tube chart over there. So how I think I want to end the video is I'm going to go into my Predicta room of goodies and my Predicta showcase and show you guys a couple other pieces kind of in theme with Immaculate and having really rare original documentation. I have a new inbox Safari that has the paperwork I'm going to show next, followed by a Safari or a 17-3 with box. Now, I don't have the paperwork for that set. I have 17-3 paperwork I bought on eBay, but it didn't come with that set, so I'm not going to misrepresent. However, still very rare to find stuff with the boxes. So
as promised, Philco Safari, the world's first portable transistor, but really first portable television, battery-powered portable television. At least that's what the marketing for Philco claims, and from all accounts, all historical accounts, that's what the history proves. I found this in an old television repair shop, or actually the home of a television repair shop owner, but he lived like right across the street from his repair shop, and he had a really awesome Philco collection that included this new inbox Safari. A couple interesting items that were included: the Philco battery, which would give you, I believe they recommended 4 hours of battery usage, and it took at least 6 to 8 hours for it to recharge. And then as well, the the paperwork, including the unfilled out warranty card, so we can send this into Philco and register our warranty. And then last but not least, of course, the set itself in the factory blue felt bag they came in. As you can see, this one is, by all accounts, fairly immaculate, but I'm going to leave the bag on it because it's a pain in the ass to get off and on. So another piece that I wanted to show, kind of went in line with this, is going to be directly next to it, the Philco 17er, Slender 17er 3. And this set I bought with the box. Now, it doesn't have any of the documentation that came with the box, it just was with the box and then the set. And this is a saddle tan 17er 3. So you never find sets with the original box. It's the only one that I have, the actual television set with the box outside of, I guess you would count this as well too. It is the portable it is a television. You just don't find Philco stuff with boxes. So they make some very remarkable and exceptionally valuable because they retained their original boxes. So I think you'd be hard pressed to find examples quite like these anywhere else. Now both of these models, I apologize. The Safari models was an H model, like the Continental previously shown. Those H models denote 1960 model year. The Slender 17er 3, along with all the other first gen Predictas, were G model or 1959 model year Predicta, which was the first run. They did it in two runs, and then after Ford bought Philco from the bankruptcy, from what we can gather historically, kind of speculation in some part, Philco had a big overstock of the 17-inch models, which is why they sold them so cheap to Holiday Inn to allow them to be a marquee item. I want to thank you guys for watching today. The next video I'm working on is trying to copy a Philco Predicta Continental back, like the one that came off of that one, for another set that I sold. Aside from that, I have a lot of other videos coming in the pipeline, so stay tuned and please like and subscribe.